Let us work on the next chakra. Next, we will be working on the root chakra, Mooladhara chakra, the chakra which is the root and base for the whole existence. Moola means root, Adhara means base. This is the energy which is the root and base for whole existence, for all cosmos. This chakra is related to sex energy. Sex energy of the human beings is the cause for the human beings' existence on the planet Earth. And sex energy of the divine is the cause for the whole existence of the universe. If this chakra starts working properly, more than 80% of our energy will be available to our being. 80% of our energy is blocked only in this chakra. Don't think our 100% energy is divided by 7 and it is invested in all the chakras. No. 80% in this one chakra. Only remaining 20% is in the all other 6 chakras. There are few basic truths to be understood about this chakra. In various ages, in various ways, this chakra gets disturbed. Let me explain in various times how this chakra is disturbed. At first, your age from 0 to 7, then from 7 to 14, then from 14 to 21, from 21 to 28. These are the 4 major zones which we need to understand how this chakra gets disturbed and what are the ways at least now to clear this energy. At least now, how can we activate this chakra properly? All fatal diseases are due to this chakra. If this chakra is not understood properly and used, your whole life contracts. If this chakra is understood, no fatal diseases will happen to your body. Let me explain layer by layer how sex happens in your body and how it is disturbed, how this chakra is condemned or disturbed in your body. At first, between the age 0 to 7, you live in the whole body. If your body is 10 square acres or 10 acres, you live throughout the 10 acre when you are taking birth. That is the reason your sensitivity is so beautiful. And you have a special grace in all culture, all over the world. You can see the kids below 7. They will have their own beauty and grace. Not only in India, take America, or even the poverty-stricken countries, even the Ethiopia, where poverty is just killing the people. Even in that country, if you see the photograph of the kids, they have their own grace. Even though they are in poverty, they have their own grace. All over the world, you can see, have you seen a single kid who is ugly? No. Same way if you see, have you seen a single grown-up man who is beautiful? kids have got their own grace because they live throughout their body. Their energy is not genitalized or centered on one point. They live throughout. They are alive, active throughout the body. By and by, our so-called bringing up, I always tell the people, we don't bring up the children, we bring them down. Understand this one word. It is not bringing up, it is bringing down. Between the age of 0 to 7, we suppress the left side of the kids. Kids are not allowed to use the left side. We don't let them use the left side. So half of their area is disconnected from them. For example, kids will automatically use the left hand also to eat, left hand also to do the work, usually, because they don't, something is right and something is left. They usually use the left hand, left leg. But in our so-called bringing up system, we suppress the left. We don't let the kids to use the left. When you suppress the left, when you don't allow the kids to use the left, half of their energy is suppressed. So 100 acres, if you are living in 100 acres, you reduce that to 50 acres. Half of their area is held as a land. They don't use that land anymore. It is just taken away from them. The next step, you make a, give a tight clothings. If you really want your kids to be alive, intelligent, don't give them tight clothings till they are 7. In America, in the West actually, they are very intelligent guys. They picked up our Gurukulam system. Till the age of 7, kids don't have to go to school. But here, we picked up their system. They picked up our system, we picked up their system. Here the Gurukulam, in our Gurukulam system, kids don't have to go to school till the age of 7. Till the age of 7, if they are given a long cloth, single piece cloth, their energy will be more sensitive, more alive, more active. In India, we make them read or write only after 7 in the Gurukulam system. Now, by the age of 3, we put them in the school. You see, kids have got a special way of thinking. It is called thinking through visualization. When you put them in the school, that is reduced to verbalization. They start thinking through verbalization. Two things you need to understand: thinking through visualization, thinking through verbalization. Thinking through visualization means it is an intelligence. Thinking through verbalization means it is an intellect. Whole joy, whole life is reduced to just words. So it's almost like a reducing the bull into bullock. Psychologically, you are depressing them. You are depriving life from them. Once they are brought down to verbalization, their whole life will be just dull. The jumping or the vibrating energy will simply disappear from them. We were all kids. We were all jumping, running around, spinning. What happened to all of us? Suddenly we became so silent. Our body languages became so dull. What has happened? There was a time, once we were all jumping and running around, our body language was just vibrant, alive. Invariably, almost everybody's body language has become so silent. How? How is it possible? Because the first thing is suppressing the left. Second thing, the tight dress which separates the lower body and the upper body. When you separate the lower body and the upper body by the tight clothings, you forget the lower body at all. For example, just close your eyes and remember your name. You will remember only your upper body. Your mind will never imagine the lower body. Only by force you have to bring lower body to your memory. By the tight dresses which separates the lower body and upper body, almost your left living in the lower body. You have vacated the lower body. They are there just hanging with the upper body. Otherwise, you don't use them. You don't live with them. How much you are sensitive in your cheeks? You are not so much sensitive in your feet. Why? Both of them are part of your body. You don't live throughout your body. That is the first blow for the Muladhara Chakra. Muladhara Chakra gets contaminated, gets disturbed in four levels. That is why this chakra is called the chakra with four petals. In four levels it gets disturbed. The first blow, first disturbance is suppressing the left and separating the lower body. The second, from 7 to 14, once your left is suppressed, you are disconnected to the feminine energy which is available in your own body. In our body, masculine and feminine energies are available. Once your left is suppressed, your own feminine energy stops working. Then you start searching for that feminine energy from outside. You wanted feminine support. Whole day you cannot be intellectual, you cannot be logical, you cannot be argumentative, you cannot be masculine. Sometime you need to rest into the feminine. Some little bit of rest is necessary. You need art, grace, love, poetry. You need little bit of feminine energy. So you start searching for the feminine energy. That is the reason between 7 to 14, almost all the male kids will be attracted to mother, all the female kids will be attracted to the father. 7 to 14, it is an unwritten law. All the male kids, they will be with the mother. All the female kids, they will be with the father. Because that is the time they need healing from the mother's presence or from the father's presence. If you want your kids to be intelligent, between the 7 and 14, they should be just around you. Not only in the same house, they should sleep in your bed. They should sleep in your lap. Physically, they should have a touch continuously with you. That heals them. That is the age the boy becomes man, girl becomes woman. So that is the age your physical energy or your just touch is needed for them. In that age, if you put them in residential school, be sure when you are old, they will put you in old age home. You teach them, because that is the age they need your energy support. When you don't give that, naturally they don't have any emotional connection with you. Between the age of 7 to 14, if you let them stay somewhere else, if you are afraid of taking their responsibility, you can be sure in future they will not have any emotional connection with you. Because you have not fulfilled them. Just by giving birth, you cannot teach them how to live. Only by making them live around you between the age of 7 and 14, your energy supports them. They flower in your presence. You know, there is a new research, beautiful research. They come up with some amazing understandings. If you plant 100 rose plants in one place, all the 100 grows beautifully. If your rose plant is up, if it grows 1%, if it is in the 100 rose plants, they say it grows at least 3 times more. Because of the presence, it naturally does something, everything grows totally. Same way, if they are around you, your presence gives them courage to grow. Every cell of your body has got its own intelligence. If they have their own intelligence, naturally they will have their own fear. Will I grow totally? Will I fulfill the purpose of my birth on the planet Earth? Every cell has got their own fear. Between 7 and 14, the fear will be in peak. your presence, your nearness, especially your physical touch to the kids will encourage them to grow totally. You are a promise for your kids. You see, I have grown up. You can also grow. It's a continuous promise so that they can trust the existence. Of course, what I am explaining is the subtle part of the sex energy. If you want really your children to grow optimum, your children to grow maximum, the best gift you can give to them is between 7 to 14, they should be around you. Not only they should be around you, they should sleep in your bed. They should just sleep in your lap. They should sleep in your bed. Your physical touch should be there for the kids. Of course, once they are 14, naturally they themselves become father or mother. They are ready to become a father or ready to become a mother. Naturally, after the age of 14, they cannot be around you. But at least till the age of 14, see that if you have the kids between 7 and 14, don't deprive them from your presence. You do not know, you do not value your presence in their life. But this is the age they really need your presence. They really need your being with them. Of course, when you deprive them, naturally you will be deprived. Then get ready, have your bag and baggages to go to the old age home. That's the truth. You may not go to old age home, but you will not have the emotional connection with them. They won't have emotional connection with you. They won't have the real feeling, love or gratitude to you. I've always seen the kids who are brought up by the father, mother, with the father, mother, staying with them between the age of 7 to 14, they have the tremendous satisfaction in their sex life because their sensitivity is too much. They are growing in a proper way. For a rose to come up, for a rose plant to flower, only water or the fertilizer is not enough. You need a good sunlight and at least a little bit of rain. Your presence is like a sunlight. It will help them to grow totally.